Good now. I hope you're doing well. Whoever and wherever you are across the world, thank you very much for tuning in and joining me. It's great to have you. It's great to be here with you. And obviously, in this video, I am going to be spending the next hour or so playing the Sorcerer class in Diablo 4. Obviously, let's load into the game. Now, here's my plan, and hopefully everything goes according to plan. I'm going to try to do a dungeon and defeat a boss. There's not going to be any spoilers in the game. I'm back here in the back alley just to avoid any players that might be going through the game. So no spoilers, no story. I have reached level 20, so there is the gems quest to unlock the ability to socket gems into items, so we'll do that. A dungeon, and then there is also the Sorcerer quest. I'm on PS5, by the way. There is the Legacy of the Magi. I feel something, a voice on the astral wind, calling out dimly. Somewhere in the mountains, is this call meant for me? I should investigate. So, and that might involve a dungeon as well. So we'll do that. And I'm not sure if you are here at what point in time you'll be watching this, but I did a video prior to this called Diablo 4 ASMR Gameplay, The 5 Classes. And I kind of went over the explore the 5 classes, spent about 15 minutes on each, but here I'll be able to spend a little bit more time on each one, a little more in depth. So with that, I currently spec'd out my sorcerer to, I am level 20, so I still have to unlock the ultimate, which I am 3 levels away from doing that, as well as the final a final passive. So I'm not sure if you are a fan of Diablo, if you're playing Sorcerer or not. I'm doing this one video dedicated to each class because I like all the classes. And also to for anyone that's maining, you know, Sorcerer or any of the other classes, to be able to kind of, you know, enjoy the class together, so to speak. Alright, so I have level 1 of Frostbolt. Throw a bolt of frost at an enemy, dealing 73 damage. Of course, the numbers changed based on gear, and chilling them for, you know, 15%. Next rank increases, you know, to 80. Modifiers, and in case you didn't know, chilling, the very bottom, it says chilled enemies have reduced movement speed. Repeatedly chilling an enemy will freeze it. Frozen enemies cannot move or attack. Enemies can be frozen by repeatedly chilling them. Alright, and the modifiers to the Frost Bolt. It has a 15% chance to explode on chilled enemies, hitting surrounding enemies. Chance increased to 100% against frozen enemies. And Frost Bolt generates 4 mana when hitting chilled or frozen enemies. So these are the modifiers right here. that I just read off, the two additional things. And, you know, you can, what's great about, you know, I hate to continue gushing and praising the game, but, you know, I've been gaming since the Atari 2600, in case you didn't know, I'm 52, as of this year, 2023. I love my games, not just video games, you know, board games, any kind of game. Anywho, what was I saying? Yeah, so one thing I love about this game is you could be both, I like to consider myself an ice sorcerer, frost sorcerer, but you can equip both fire and ice. I mean, you could go select all four of the basic skills if you wanted. So that's awesome. You can mix and match, modify the skills if you want. I didn't have to choose these two modifiers, and I could have put the extra 2 points into the skill itself. But I kind of like, branching out, so to speak, and, getting some benefit from the modifiers. Now, based on the modifiers that I've chosen, I'm going for like a mana regeneration and build somewhat. So that's the basic skill. Doesn't cost any mana to cast. All right, and then the core skill, I've chosen Frozen Orb. It sends out a spinning orb of ice, goes a certain distance, then explodes, hitting all enemies in its path. So it's like an AoE, a moving projectile AoE, I guess you could say. So unleash an orb that chills for X% and expels piercing shards, dealing a total of X damage. Upon expiration, it explodes, dealing more damage and chilling enemies. Alright, so the modifiers I have for that are enhanced frozen orb. When cast above 50 mana, the explosion damage is increased. And then of the additional modifiers, I chose destructive frozen orb. The explosion restores mana. I could have chosen that the explosion has a percent to make enemies vulnerable for 2 seconds, or makes vulnerable enemies frozen. But a chance of doing that compared to guaranteed mana restoration, I'd rather take the guaranteed mana restoration so that I have a chance to cast more spells. So that's the core. And again, I mean, you could take the one basic skill, not modify it, and then dump more points into multiple core skills. So you can really, it's pretty cool. I'm not here to promote the product. I'm just a fan of games. And I'm not getting paid to, do this or anything, so. And the additional points I put into core skills, I put 2 into devastation. My maximum mana is increased by 6. For my defensive skills, I chose ice armor. A barrier of ice forms around you for X seconds, absorbing certain amount of base life in damage. While it is active, certain small percentage of damage dealt is added to its barrier. For the modifiers, I had to choose enhanced ice armor. When ice armor is active, increases my mana regeneration. And then I also chose mystical ice armor. Damage against vulnerable enemies contributes a percentage more to ice armor's barrier. So damage against vulnerable enemies keeps the ice armor, not the time that it stays up, but the amount of protection it provides. I could have chosen Shimmering Ice Armor, where there is a chance that enemies become frozen. But I'd rather have a guaranteed thing than a small chance. You know, I don't know. That's just me. Okay, moving on to the conjuration skills. Again, you know, I could be a mix of frost and fire, or electricity, but I'm kind of sticking with the frost theme. Something about it that I like. The effects and the mechanics. So I chose ice blades. Conjure a pair of ice blades for X seconds that rapidly slash enemies and have a chance to make them vulnerable. I also chose enhanced ice blades. Helps reduce the cooldown each time they hit a vulnerable enemy. And then the additional modifier is I get a 10% increased attack speed per active ice blade. So could have chosen the other modifier where there's a 20% of enhanced ice blades cooldown reduction is applied to your other skills. You know. Of course, there's a lightning spear and the Hydra. Moving on to mastery skills, which spend mana to dominate the battlefield. I didn't choose anything yet. Oh wait, I did choose. Sorry, I thought I didn't. All right, totally got confused there. So yeah, so I chose Blizzard, and it continually chills enemies, eventually freezing them, and I love it. And I chose the enhanced Blizzard modifier, which increases the damage against frozen enemies. And then the additional modifier I've selected, when it's active, my core skills cost 10% less mana. I could have chosen that the Blizzard's duration is increased by 4 seconds when cast above 50 mana. I mean, you know, 6 of one, half a dozen of the other. I don't know. I kind of liked reducing the mana cost on my core skills, which are up here, and the only one is the Frozen Orb. So, so that's it. So, 3 more skills to unlock, I think, my ultimate? Or is that down here? Anyway. I think my ultimate right here, right? Yeah, this is the ultimate. So 3 more levels to get to that, and I don't think in this video we'll be getting down to, the passive. I think that's a passive down there, right? Yeah, key passive. Okay, one other look at, my items, just a bunch of rares. You know, I'm not gonna go over them too much. There's my inventory, there's my cursor. Alright, so... I don't want to, you know, we've already been here for about, 10 minutes or so, close to 15, so let's get moving. Let's go, do that, quest real quick. I was going to think about doing the gem crafting quest. Let's do the quest of the, a class-specific quest. We'll travel to Nevesque, and we'll do that sorcerer-specific quest, which I'm assuming unlocks, something related. Let's just put a marker there so I can follow a path. Try to get there as quickly as we can. And we'll do some combat on the way. Do that blizzard attack. I'm out of mana. Ice shield. Put up the... I just love that. How it freezes enemies. And Oh, do I have a whispering? I don't have a whispering key. Let me see if we can jump real quick to Kyovishad. Pick up a whispering key. jump back. I think that whispering chest is first come, first serve. See if we can get it real quick. It's kind of early in the morning. Let's see if we can. We can do another random quest if we want. I have the sound of the game down, so you can just hear everything. There we go. Let's jump back. Do I have a portal? Yeah, I have a portal. Let's go to the portal. The portal should take me right to the Whispering Key chest. That's what's cool about this game. As long as you don't leave town, the last place that you were, that you portaled out of... I got lost. I got confused for a second, which happens when you get older. Anyway, I feel like video games keep me sharp a little bit. Alright. This should drop me right where I took the portal from the chest. There it is, still there. See what we get. A bunch of gold. Got an amulet and a ring. Let's see what we got. Where's my... you can see it flashing there. There's the ring. We can compare it to what I have already. I have, the ring I have now has less resistance, but it increased crit strike chance. So I'm trying to build up some crit strike chance. So I'm keeping that one. And then an amulet that has increased resistance, damage reduction to when I get control impaired. So we'll equip that. Alright, let us continue. Get my ice storm going. My blizzard. Get out of the way. Well, I always get shot by that. Using that, you see that basic skill doesn't cost anything. There's the blizzard. See, I can just slow them, freeze them from a distance. The problem with the blizzard is some enemies will start at a location, you'll cast the blizzard, but then they'll move through it, come closer to you, so you gotta cast it again. Oh, did I kill him already? Alright, oh, there we go. I do have a shield, but I'm not really too concerned of using this shield with overland mobs. I forget the name of the core skills. I got to assign my skill point, too. I forgot to do that. Where are my... I keep forgetting the name. Oops. Try to bring them... lure them into... Okay, they're not gonna... Sometimes you have to try to corral your enemies into the little AoE that you cast. Alright, I have one more point to spend. Let's see. Your barriers have a 5% increased duration. Ooh, I like that. Yeah, let's put a point in there. Every little point helps. Whether you put them all into one, spread them out. I mean, it's all kind of the same, really. I just love it. I love that. I gotta remember the names of the skills real quick. So it's a Frost Bolt, Blizzard. Oh no, Frozen Orb. That's the one. Ice Shield, Ice Armor, Ice Blades. Blizzard. So, Frozen Orb. That's that. Keep forgetting the name. Oh, another player down here. Alright, let's go down. There is a little, I could go in there and do this little haunted barrow, little mini dungeon. These are kind of fun. Sometimes it might be a quest in here. Sometimes it might be a challenge. Defeat everything in a certain amount of time. I just love all the details. Oh. See, I'm trying to get them to go into the storm. This looks like it's going to be speak to the wandering soul. They've been feeding on me, my soul. Please take it back from them. Let it end. So this is going to be like defeat everything in a certain time, I think. Yeah, survive the onslaught. Let's go up here, get everybody frozen. Frozen Frostbolt. Keep the storm going and the frozen orb. Bring out my ice blades. My ice shield, or my ice armor, I should say. Cast ice blades again, cast blizzard. It's hard to make sure I'm not, whoops, get out of, I always get hit by that. Cast the blizzard again. Get some ice storms going. I don't know why I cast blizzard there. Get the wraith. Slay, okay. Alright, so I didn't get the mastery. Slay soul imbued enemies while defending the wandering soul. So I kind of lost track. There's a lot to focus on. You gotta, you know, micromanage what skills you cast and what you're gonna cast next and where you are on the screen, relationship to your enemies. Eyeballs, whatever. Crude emerald and a ring and some pots, healing pots. Let's go check out my inventory. What do I have new? Right here I have the crude emerald, which can be turned into an emerald. And I have an imposing ring. Increases the cold and shadow resistance and plus 7 damage to stunned enemies. Let's go up to my rings I have equipped. One has 1.4 crit chance. The other one has 1.4 crit chance. So do I want to increase my crit chance, which is currently 10.2, reduce it down to 8, and get 7% damage to stunned enemies. You know, so I'm going to keep the crit chance. Since everything scales, you know, it doesn't really, just leave, it doesn't really matter too much. You know, it's not like if things didn't scale, then I would need to constantly, you know, make sure I'm improving my powers and have the best weapons and everything. Put my ice shield up. Cast my blizzard, frozen orb. That's great. Feels really good. This is what suits me. Blizzard, frozen orb, destroyed. Okay, so I have to find, now where it is, there it is. So I gotta find, I don't want to get involved with the event. Okay, here we go. I was wondering what the point of this area was. I was playing another character and there was nothing happening over here. Alright, Mordorin Traveling Sorcerer.
Too long and too far for the hidden arc. I'm looking for a book known as the Forgotten Codex.
Okay.
To be in the archives.
All right.
According to legend, the Forgotten Codex is a compendium of enchantment techniques developed by the Aenir mage clan. Some say Zoltan Kuhl himself was
one. Zoltan Kuhl himself. Wow.
The place is overrun with demons beyond my skills.
Psh, if whatever.
You can retrieve the codex, I can teach you the magic.
Ooh, okay.
Could be an excellent outcome for both of us, eh?
Hmm, yeah, I think
I'll
so.
See what I can do.
I'll see what I can do. Alright, okay, what do I have to do? Recover the Forgotten Codex. Oh, I gotta do a dungeon. There we go, the Lost Archives. Okay. I pretty much have... That's like the first... Once I get out of the starting area here, this is another cool aspect. The whole beginning area here, all the enemies change. So you go through this area first, and then you reach Kyovastad. Let me zoom out. And then when you reach here, and then you go back, like new things open up and everything changes. So that was a really cool. I wasn't expecting that. So that's a pretty cool thing. All right, the Lost Archives. This will probably take about 15 minutes to go through. I've done this already a couple times on different alts. So, just go through. I'll try not to spend too much time going through everything, but I do want to find some chests. You know, I don't explore every nook and cranny. I won't be here forever, but trying to get through here as quick as possible. Just looking for any... There's a chest. Let's see what we get. Some gold. Okay. It's alright. There we go. Put my ice shield up. Gotta watch out. Gotta watch out for those... Oh yeah, the shaman. You gotta watch out for those shaman. They will explode corpses at your feet. So you always have to be ready to move. Alright, we have a boss. Okay, put my shield up. I don't hear a shaman. Better heal up. Taking some damage. Why am I... Okay. I don't know why I was standing right there so close. I should have moved out of the storm so everybody gets slowed and chilled. Okay. Oops. I meant to... Yeah. I'm gonna jump back to town real quick. I'm not fully immersed in the game because I'm making a video, but this happens. So we'll travel back to Nevesque, repair my armor, and come right back to that portal. Like I said, this is pretty cool. So I have to, I'm trying to, if I wasn't making a video and have my mind fully focused, But I'm trying to, not just play the game and not talk or whatever. So let's just repair. There. Okay. And jump back to the portal. Alright. Go right back into the dungeon. I might have to drop the world tier level. I have to try to just play a little smarter. I shouldn't have died, really, I don't think. I think I aggroed some more monsters I shouldn't have aggroed. Alright, so let's try this again. Get out of that AoE. Cast my blades. Cast the blizzard shield. Yeah, I think we're doing a little bit better. Well, I don't have any adds. Additional. Yeah, so. Obviously, I took it down without. Okay. Oh, yeah, there's the shaman. That thing might have played a role in my death. There we go. Alright. Yeah, I think I attracted some additional enemies. And, oops, okay. Better heal up, cast my shield. Cast blizzard. So blizzard kinda is like, slows enemies down a little bit. Why did I cast blizzard out there? I hear that shaman. Try to go for that shaman. Side of the ice storm or the blizzard. There we go. Freeze and explode. And we got over here. Nothing. Okay. Another boss up there. See, that's the thing with the blizzard. Heal up. I don't think it's in the blizzard. I'm trying to get. Oh no. Get those things. Too great. I got too much stuff. I gotta go sell stuff. Okay, I need to drop some stuff. Let's. Again, this is a really cool feature. I don't know too many other games that you can do this. We're gonna take a hop over to Kyovashad. This is cool. I mean, I didn't want to have to do this in the game, but this is cool because this is what you will experience sometimes. So. Let's go put the gems. Let's just drop everything into the chest for now. The gems first, right? We'll do that. And then, now real quick, let's just mark some things as junk or equip some things. Okay, 14 intelligence. That's all right, I'll trash that, and we'll trash just anything. Let's see. Ooh, there's a staff. right now, a dagger has, yeah. Why do I have just a regular staff anyway? Interesting. Oh no, what am I doing? Yeah. There we go. Okay. Let's teleport back. Oh, no. What am I doing? Yeah, I gotta sell a bunch of stuff, make room in the inventory. I was gonna dump everything, but might as well equip some things. Try to do this as quick as I can. Only have so much time here. Alright, I'm going to my inventory. What do we have? My focus. Cooldown reduction. It does less damage. Oh, I don't have a focus equipped. That's right, I've been using a focus. Yeah. No, I've been using this. The Beast Source, a rare focus. And then, where's my... There's my dagger. So a staff is two-handed, but I like to use a wand or a dagger, and then a focus. Okay, let's, that's just regular, common trash. We'll just mark that. Keepsake, focus, it's magic, it's not rare, so we'll trash that, Junk, mark it for junk, is what I mean. And, let's see, additional armor. I don't know. We'll do trash that. Focus, we'll trash that. We'll mark it for trash, is what I mean. Additional cold resistance and shadow resistance. Okay. Plus 7 damage, percent damage to stunned enemies. Let's equip that. I'm going to need some cold resistance where in the dungeon that I'm in. 8% cold. 6% cold. We'll trash that. I'd rather keep some critical strike chance. Amulet. We'll equip that one. Let's see, the pants. I have better rare pants. So, we'll trash that. Mark that as junk. Mark the staff as junk. Let's see. There's armor and intelligence. Compared to the armor that I have. Yeah, let's equip the magic armor. Gives me 14 intelligence. Increases my attack power and armor a little bit. And let's see, we have a wand here versus the dagger. Let's see. Dagger on the left, 6% damage to close, 6.5% to distant, 7% to slowed, 3.5% to crowd controlled. The wand is 3% lucky hit chance, 6% all stats, 5%. We'll just mark that as junk. And we'll equip the rare helm that has a lot more armor and some additional traits. Let's see, the chest armor. We'll mark that as junk. Mark the skull focus as junk. Junk. Pants. Additional armor and a dodge chance. But my other pants right now have plus 4 life regen. Damage reduction from close enemies. So we'll keep the pants I have on now. We'll equip these rare gloves. I get a plus 1 rank of frozen orb. Oh, that's awesome. Do that. We have a helm. A plus 3 maximum life. Plus 1 rank of lightning spear. I'm not using that. Hide pants. And what do we have here? A gold ring. Cold and poison resistance increase, plus percentage to lightning damage, increase the lucky hit chance, damage to distant enemies. Well, it increases my cold, so we'll, but then drop my crit. Trying to see, and let's increase it, let's equip it. Unequip that ring, equip that one. Okay. And then we'll pop that box open, get some rubies and gems, speak to the blacksmith, and then we will salvage all junk. And then let's just get out of here and let's go back to the dungeon. I'm just going to put the rest of this stuff in the chest. Normally I would spend more time making comparisons between the different things, but I don't want to do that right now. And let's just do that. There we go. Okay, let's get back to the mission that we were on, well, that I was on. Gateway to Learning. Now we have freed up our inventory, so hopefully we can finish this. Okay, there's a boss up here. Where are you? Which way? We're gonna have to go up here and probably come back. Okay. See how quickly we can do this. Oh, it's not a boss. It's an elite. Cool. That door opens. Well, that's done that before. Anyway. Okay, so here's the two podiums. Pedestals. Shaman. Gotta go after the shaman. They cause too much. They make too much trouble. Okay. I'm not gonna. Okay. Alright. So we still have a little bit to explore down here, but in the interest of time. Of time. That's when I can't keep moving here. Nice. Froze it before it could do anything. Pop my shield. Let's get out of the storm. See if I can get out of the blizzard. There we go. Heal up. Let's just keep going. We had to find there's a name for it. I forget offhand. Why did I drink a pot? I didn't mean to hit the pot. Sometimes I lose a little track of controls. I'm a little older, obviously, so I'm not as sharp as I was 20 years ago in my 30s. But as I kind of mentioned earlier, giving up alcohol and I think has helped me stay a little sharper. Not that I was ever a heavy drinker. I was always just a moderate drinker, but still. Anyway, I'm not going into a whole big thing about that. Whoops. But I think playing video games helps to keep you sharp a little bit. I'd like to think. Alright. Cool. What do we have here? Lethal Shrine. Oh, that's gonna pop out an explosion, right? Or does that just increase my... Let's get rid of that wrath. Oh, they all have, like, extended health. Pop my ice armor. Cool. Alright. Okay, so this area is almost cleared. Shattering Wrath. Wraith. Wow, we have a whole bunch of things going on right here. Everything has extended, increased health. Just to keep everything in the storm. Corral everything into the storm. That's why I'm evading to the other side of the storm, or to get away from the enemies so I can keep them in the storm, keep them slowed, frozen. Okay, there might be a chest or something, but you can... Three shaman. Nice. Get that other shaman out of the way. Can't freeze this elite. Or did I freeze it? I think I did freeze it. Take a look at my gear real quick. We have a rare wand. Damage over time. Lucky hit. Damage to stun. Vulnerable damage. Yeah, why not give it a try? Can socket something in there, but it's okay. Plus one rank of all conjuration skills. Mana cost reduction. Yeah, why not? And that's a wand. Let's see what we have. Looks like, yeah, we'll equip that one. My attack power is 299. Oh, it jumps up to 318. Because of my intelligence increase. Or no. Oh, because of just the damage per second, I guess. Let's see, intelligence grants me additional skill damage and resistance to elements. So it's, if I equip... Alright, I don't want to spend... Let's just keep the one with the intelligence. It increases my spell power. I don't want to spend too much time here. I mean, we've been here for... we've been here for 50 minutes already. I thought I could do a lot more in the time. Probably spent too much time in the beginning of the video talking about stuff, but... I hear a shaman. Get rid of that shaman. There we go. Okay, let's find the other box. I think we need to complete this. Oh, we have a shrine. Let's grab that shrine. Protection shrine. That works. We'll pop my ice armor anyway. There we go. I want to complete this quest to see what it unlocks. Get rid of that shaman. I don't need it exploding corpses. I don't want that shaman exploding corpses at my feet or doing whatever else it does. Pop my ice armor. It's pretty much the same routine over and over, but I like it. I really like the feel of the ice. Oh, let's get out of there. I just really like the feel of the ice sorcerer. See what's in this room. Nothing in there. Okay, let us continue. Get out of there. And all these things. Oh, not all of them. That's an elite. Try to keep it in. Oh, I dashed and I evaded into the. See if I can get it to come into the. There we go. Got some sturdy boots. Sturdy boots. Increase the dodge chance. Additional dexterity. Rank of ice armor. Yeah, why not? Another rank of ice armor can't hurt. Oh, I saw you. Oh, there you are. Okay. Should be getting close. Everything in the blizzard. Try to keep everything chilled and slowed down. Sometimes it casts it where you don't want it to be cast. There we go. Another blizzard right there. It's a little difficult trying to control where you want that blizzard to go. Injured adventurer. Okay, I gotta find. Oh, there it is. Looks like I have to go right down here. Okay. I'm not worried about the injured adventurer. Let's get the box. Oh, there's a whole bunch coming. There's no shaman, which is good. Cast my ice armor, but wasn't ready yet. Okay, let's get the box. this is part of the quest. Dust-covered chest. Okay, this is part of the quest right here. Didn't even notice it on my mini-map. The Forgotten Codex. All right. I don't really have to do this. This will kill two birds with one stone. I wanted to do a dungeon boss anyway. So we are here. And let's try to do the dungeon boss. Now, I'm on world tier 2. And, I don't know if I'll be able to do it. I have another, skill point. See, do I have any... where's the increase in the duration of my barriers? When you have a barrier active, you apply 8% more chill. Let's increase the barrier duration, maybe by a second and a half or something. Okay, so the thing here is, if I can't defeat this boss at world tier 2 and I leave to decrease the world tier, it's gonna erase my portal and I'll have to go through the entire dungeon and do it all over again, do all this over again at world tier 1. So, let's just give this a shot, see if I can do this with my, shaman that explodes corpses. I'm not sure if my... Alright, so here they all come. Let's see how well I can do. Hold up. Got it. As long as we stay out of the reach of the corpses. Get out of that. Let's go over here. Keep everything chilled and frozen in my storm. I think as long as... Yeah, as long as we stay out of the reach of the exploding corpses. We might be okay. If I can keep the adds. Yeah, as long as it doesn't grab that pot real quick. So this is gonna be a long battle. It's okay if I don't, if I die. If I can keep, there we go. So if I can keep I'm down to it's gonna be a long battle, like I said. If I can keep got some more pots, that's good. Now it's gonna, is it gonna raise anything? It's not raising any enemies, so just try to keep everything frozen, slowed. Okay, cool. All right, another round, another wave. Grab that pot. Stay out of the range. Stay out of the range. Yeah, we got it down to less than half. I'll grab some of those pots. don't think I can do anything with these things. Another wave. Get my shield up. Make sure I... I might actually do this. I think I gotta... just kind of stay out of the range. Getting close. Another wave is coming. Just be smart. Be patient. Cool. More pots. That helps. Yeah, we got this. Gotta heal up. Don't want to die just yet. Just when we're getting to the end. Don't want to die. Okay. Just about dead. And there we go. Alright. Did it. Cool. Still can go through the dungeon more, but, you know, like, we've been here for just about an hour. I did the quest. We completed, can I just leave? There we go. So we got the quest complete. And we got, like I said, two birds with one stone. Completed the quest. And, and completed the dungeon. So that worked out perfect. I wanted to do both of those things, and we got them done. All right, let's listen to Mordrin Hastet. What? Get out of here. Here are the codex pages. Secrets.
We will work together.
Huh.
I have prepared for this ritual.
Okay. Looks like probably another. Probably gonna fight something again. Into the abandoned shack. I love abandoned shacks. Let's see what rituals.
Let me get these incantations sorted properly. Would you be so kind as to light the elemental braziers?
Yeah, I can do that. Even though I'm an ice wizard.
Sparks of fire, here heaps of earth, hear us. Tides of water, hear us. Gales of air, hear us.
This is cool. I love this stuff. Oh, I gotta talk to him again.
Looks like some of these pages are damaged. No matter. I can infer the meaning from context.
Okay. Yeah.
I refuse to let caution keep me from the secrets of this book. I've come too far.
Yeah, I'd probably do the same thing.
Great powers of the elemental forces.
Uh-oh. I'm leaving. I'm scared. I'm gonna hide behind the table. Yeah, I'm gonna hide. Can I crouch? Can I, like, hide in the cabinet? Oh no. Jeez, I didn't expect this. Alright, it's gonna be wave after wave for a little bit. Start out kind of weak, I guess. and then get stronger. That's what I'm assuming. All right, not too bad. Are you all right?
I don't know what to say. I'm certain my interpolations were correct. Or at least in the spirit of the original.
Sure.
All this wasted effort.
Yeah.
Perhaps my translation of the book was incorrect.
Probably.
Going back to Kuras to study my notes again.
Yeah, good.
I think it's best if I leave the book with you.
Mm-hmm.
Consider it thanks for your help.
Okay. Very, thank you. All right. I'm assuming. Let's see. Class feature unlock. Enchantment slot unlocked. Enchantment slot. Where's my enchantment slot? Enchantment slot. What are you talking about? Am I supposed to be... So these are just all gems. These are just things that can be socketed. Another enchantment slot. Consumables, quest, aspects. Enchantment slot. I think that might have to do with enchanting things. I was expecting something to appear on the screen here, like with the druid. And the necromancer. Okay. Alright. Alright, so... Yeah, that's it for this. I guess... We'll go back to... I guess it's gonna provide additional service. Enchantment unlocked. Yeah, let's go back to Kyobishad. I'm assuming there is a gem, a cultist. Yeah, maybe that has something to do with it. We'll go back to Kyobishad and we'll see exactly what yeah, there is. Oh, I think the gem quest. Well, we might as well take care of the gem quest. It's not much of a quest, but. I'm just going to skip the dialogue for time. Basically, I unlocked the ability to craft gems. So I have to craft a gem to complete the quest. So we go up here to. I don't know, what should we craft? Craft a skull. Because increases armor, you get life on kill. There's diamond, ultimate skill damage. There's nothing that increases crit chance, but, you know, who knows? I mean, they could add a ton more, I'm sure, though, with the future seasons. We'll probably have, you know, they can't put everything into the game. They have some content to release with each season. So who knows, maybe we'll get a gem that increases a crit chance. We'll do craft a skull. I have eight crude skulls. It only takes 3 to make 1. And there we go. And I completed the quest for the gem crafting. Now, so I can socket and unsocket things. Alright, let us... Oh, this is not yet. I can't access the occultist yet. I'm still kind of... Oh wait, what was that? Codex of Power? No. That's not. What is it talking about? A about additional enchantments. Hold on, I'm going to have to Google that real quick. Okay, so I unlocked an additional enchantment slot for the sorcerer. Apparently, the other classes can just have one, but I can't enchant anything because you can only unlock the occultist at level 25, I think. Yeah. And I am level 21. So, 4 more levels. And we've been here for a little over an hour. I don't know. I'm close to level 22. I don't know if I have time in here to unlock. Let's see. What should we do? Do another dungeon. I'm not sure if that's going to give us... It's going to take like another half an hour to unlock those additional levels, I think, to get to level 25. It's not going to happen in the next 5 minutes. Alright, so that is the sorcerer. I never did respec. Played around with that. But, this video, I just wanted to do, you know, a little more, playing with the sorcerer and, dedicated video to playing the sorcerer for you or for anyone out there that is maining the sorcerer, or plans to make it, one of their alts. And that's really it. So, go up here, out of the way. So, I think that'll do it. I can slot. Let's finish up. Let's get some, gems. We'll craft a few gems, and we'll slot a few. Oh, I went the long way. I could have gone right next to the jeweler. Let's grab all my gems. I could have gone right to the jeweler this way. Right this way. Alright, so let's craft another chip skull, craft a diamond, craft a sapphire, craft a topaz, craft a ruby, craft an emerald, craft an amethyst. I think that's good enough. Okay, now let's take a final look at my gear. Let's just get a little private space. We'll go up here where this... Is that someone right there doing something? We got somebody over on the bench. Okay. Alright, so let's see what we have that we can slot. There we have some rare chest armor. Put a socket in that. And we have a ring. Let's unequip... I don't have enough inventory space. Okay. Let's just temporarily drop common gloves. We'll unequip the lurking phase ring. And we'll equip that gold ring. Oh, actually. Let's see. Yeah. Equip the one I upgraded. Alright, now to decide what, I'm going to click on the left stick on my controller, and it pops up this additional screen. Now some of these gems will boost my resistance, So sometimes I will socket a gem based on its resistance and not so much the other stats it provides. So right here I have, I could use a gem that boosts up my cold resistance. So which gem is that? Go across the bottom real quick here. So the blue gem. Okay, that makes sense. Blue, cold. And the topaz is lightning. Is the ruby fire? Yeah, so they have the colors of the gems associated with the colors of the elements, pretty much. Lightning is kind of silvery blue, but so they had to decide which color to give lightning. So cold and blue kind of makes sense. Alright, so let's equip. We'll slot the cold resistance gem into the one ring. And we have a skull, which increases life on kill, healing received, and armor. I like those. We'll slot two of those. Oh no, I slotted the wrong one. Slotted the crude skull. And you gotta make sure you're slotting the chipped. Now I gotta pay to unsock it. Four thousand just to unsock it. Okay. So where's the chipped skull? Right there. There we go. You can see the chipped versus crude. The crude still will provide stats and buffs, but like half. So a crude skull plus 2 life on kill. Chipped skull plus 5. So we'll slot 1, 2 chipped skulls. Take a look at my resistances again. And my cold is up to 22. That's good. All my resistances are 20% or higher, so that's good. Alright, let's see. What other... we can increase the chipped diamond. I haven't unlocked the ultimate yet, but I'm only 1 or 2 skill points away from that. So let's equip the chipped diamond into the amulet. There we go. You can also add more slots, which is cool. I mean, tell you, they thought about everything with this game. All right, I have 2 more slots. What do we have? Fire resistance, overpower damage, 2.5% maximum life. So we'll add the ruby to that. And how about the topaz? 12% basic skill damage, armor, 7% damage reduction while control impaired, and lightning resistance. So yeah, let's equip a topaz. And yeah, so take a look at my stats again. My crit strike chance is 7.5. That could sure use a boost. So I'm going to keep my eye out on for any crit chance items. Yeah, so overpower 80%, vulnerable damage only 20%. That could probably use a boost. Damage versus close 11%. Okay. Alright. Where's my mana regen? Mana regen is 10 per second. So that's pretty good, I think. Not bad. And my resistance is okay. And if I wanted to socket, add some more sockets, I can do that. But I'm going to save that for any legendaries that I get. And yeah, that's going to do it. And I'll do it for this video. So thank you very much for tuning in, for watching. And if you are playing a sorcerer yourself, hope you have fun. Or maybe you're playing another character. or doing it while you're watching this, or doing something else altogether. All right, so I'm just going to end here. We're going to fade out. I'm just going to kind of fade out, end the video here as I go over my equipment. So this was one part in a 5-part series. I'm doing a video every day if you're watching this when they're being published. But if you're watching this video in the future, I'm doing one video somewhat early in the game here for each class. So this is Sorcerer, next class. I'll probably do is Rogue. And then one every day. Alright, so that'll do it. So for me, to you, have fun, stay safe, stay well. I wish you all my best. And I hope to see you in another video real soon. Maybe even tomorrow, if you're going to be watching every day. And no, I'm not turning my channel into a gameplay channel, but I am going to introduce more video games as I've kind of figured out kind of how to do it here on my channel, intersperse them. I'm not done with role plays, or I'm not done with any of the content. Just taking a break, mixing things up. Alright. So, take care for now. Alright. So, mark that for trash. And we'll mark those boots for trash. Let's see. Magic focus. Oh. 3.9% total cooldown reduction. Oh, but that's not as good as my rare focus that's equipped. It has a couple more stats. So we'll mark that for junk. Simple dagger. We'll mark that for junk. Amulet is common. Mark that. Mark all the common stuff junk. Well, that was the only few things. I'm going to mark that ring as junk. Doesn't have a socket. Mark that amulet is junk. The magic gloves increases my intelligence. Nah, it's not as good as my... it's okay. Gonna get so many different types of gear anyway all the time. Alright, so mark those as junk. Mark that tunic as junk. Mark... Yeah, we'll mark that focus as junk. That wand. Yeah, mark that as junk. And a rare dagger. Let's see. Let's equip the dagger. Even though I'm losing. Right, so I'm not fading out just yet. But I want to equip the dagger. Because it has damage to distant, to closed, to close, crowd controlled, and to slowed, whereas the dagger has plus 13 intelligence, but only damage to close, and, you know, it's increased core skill. So I like the other dagger that I just equipped. It damages all different enemies based on crowd closeness, distance. So yeah, and I can add a gem slot to it. And one little trick is you can actually tell the blacksmith to salvage what's in your inventory. If you salvage an item, and I learned this from someone on Reddit, if you salvage all junk and there's a gem in it, apparently the gem, you won't get it back. But if you go by salvage what's in your inventory, you'll get the gem back. So watch. And I should have got the ruby back. And let's upgrade while we're here. The last thing I want to do. Let's just upgrade some of the things just for fun. Doesn't cost much, and I have a lot of mats. So upgrade. I'll upgrade two levels. Oops. Go back again. Go to upgrade. Go over to... We'll upgrade the chest armor. Oops, no. I was trying to repair, upgrade chest armor. One, two. Upgrade the gloves. Upgrade the boots. Just two levels. Oh, I upgraded my magic boots. I could only upgrade those two levels. I thought they were rare. I didn't want to upgrade the magic boots, but I probably upgraded the wrong boots. Take a look here. The other boots grant me cold resistance, mana cost reduction, but the ones I have now give me a max evade charge of +1. Increase my ice armor. Okay. Wait, I don't know. Okay, I don't know what I just did. Whatever. Okay. Anyway. They're magic boots. Oh, okay, they are still magic, even though they show as rare. Okay, whatever. Okay, let's just continue upgrading. Upgrade the rare dagger. Do that once and twice. Then we'll upgrade that focus once and twice. And then we can upgrade the, my jewelry. So let's run over there real quick and upgrade. Go to upgrade and we'll upgrade the lurking phase ring. 1, 2. 2 is good enough. I don't want to upgrade anything to 3 just yet. Upgrade that. 1, 2. And then upgrade the other ring. 1, 2. And I think that upgrade the amulet. Wait. I carry the best. Was I upgrading things in my inventory? I think I was upgrading things in my inventory. Sometimes when you click on something, it highlights the things that I'm equipped, and I thought I was, I equipped the wrong things. Okay, whatever. I mean, I upgraded the wrong things, I think. Okay, no, I'm good. So there we go. Alright, so that's gonna do it for now. Alright, see you later. Just get rid of my junk. Make sure anything I'm gonna trash doesn't have anything socketed. Okay, nothing's socketed. Good. Alright, just... Oh no, wrong person. Blacksmith. All junk. There we go, that's good enough. And then we'll deposit my gems. And then we can take a look at my stats one final time. Get rid of all the... Just put those back into my vault for now. And we'll take a look at my... Look at my gear. Just go over here. Place not so busy with other folks moving around. And, take a look at my stats based on everything that I've upgraded. Weapon damage, weapon speed, crit strike, still the same. Overpowered damage, I think that's increased 67%. Vulnerable damage, 20%. Damage versus close, 13. Versus distance, 7.8. Versus slowed, 17. 13.4, so that will help against the ice. Enemies affected by chill. Resistances are up pretty good. Mana regen still at 10, 3% mana regen cost.